Hello there, boys and girls of the Minecraft universe. Centronet here with another update video on the channel. And today we are messing around in the Java version of Minecraft. We are in snapshot 20W18A, and today we're going to take a look at ruined portals. So I have been messing around with structure blocks, which is a boatload of fun because I haven't done a whole lot with structure blocks before, but I've been going through and messing with all of the new structures that we're going to get in 1.16, the Nether update. And I went through and I created all of the different variants of the ruined portals. So now let's get a little bit of Reedy Bit done really fast. So ruined portals generate in all biomes in both the Nether and the overworld. They can spawn underground, underwater, or be exposed to the air. If they generate underground, they will have air pockets around them. Natural terrain around ruined portals generates as netherrack. They will also generate a mass of netherrack underneath them. Let's go ahead and we will dive right in and take a look at the different types of ruined portals we're getting in the Nether update. All right, guys, so we have 10 regular portals, and we have 3 really large portals. So let's go ahead and we will go right down the line and I'll tell you what I've been able to find out about these. So this is portal number 1. Portal number 1 is incomplete and it actually contains no lava. Does have a loot chest. The loot does vary. So this is really just an example that generated when I used the structure block. Here is portal number 2. It is a hanging portal, which is really, really, really interesting. Does have gold blocks. You'll see gold blocks littered throughout all these, which is really cool. And this one does have lava, unlike the first one. Here is number 3. Number 3 is a small incomplete portal with no gold blocks. So you are not guaranteed to get gold blocks with all of them. Here's something I wanted to show you guys. You can get grapples or enchanted golden apples or notch apples or whatever you guys want to call them in the chests that come with these portals. So there's another source for those. I need that on Broke Rock right now. All right, here's number 4. Number 4 is just another small incomplete portal. This one does have gold blocks and it does have lava and it does come with gold with a loot chest as well. Here is number 5, another small portal where the top of the portal has fallen over. So this is the one that I showed in my structured showcase video that came out last week. Here is number 6. Number 6 is a 5x5 portal where just one block is misplaced, and that is the top center block. So this one is almost a complete portal. So if you find that one when you're running around, you're really, really lucky. Here is number 7. It is an incomplete portal that has been submerged in lava. That's pretty interesting. I like the fact that they tried to be creative with the way that they designed these. So I like this. Again, with this one, you do get the gold blocks. You get a chest as well. All right, moving on. Here is number 8. Number 8 is an incomplete portal at the top of a staircase, and the top has fallen into lava. As you can see, we have our stairs, and there's the top of our portal down there in lava. So good luck getting that out of there. But it does look like you have all the pieces you need to put that one together. Here is number 9. This is another small incomplete portal. They're all different, which is really, really great. Let's see what's going on in the chest here. Anything good? Yeah, I like the fact that it gives us another place for loot, because loot is always good. Here's number 10. This is the last of the small portals. It is an incomplete portal that has fallen backwards into lava. So you know what? This one might be more like the one that I did in the structure video for 1.16. I don't know, I'm gonna have to go back and look. They're very similar, but you can clearly see the differences. And I like the blocks that are being used. And again, we got great loot. I like it. I like it a lot. Wow, this one even comes with flint and steel. I should go back and check the other chests, but they give you just about everything you need to get the portals going. Now let's go ahead and we will run over here and take a look at the large portals next. All right, guys, so they call these giant portals. I've been calling them large portals, but we do get 3 of these. These things are monsters. They're absolutely enormous. Oops, got a little bit of redstone sitting there that shouldn't be there from when I was generating these bad boys. So here comes number 1 of the giant portals. So you get your 2 gold blocks, and There is a loot chest on this one. It is an incomplete portal. Look at the way that they're using the stone. I love this one. This one looks really cool. And I love the way that they incorporated the iron fences in there as well. And here is number two. Again, two gold blocks. Portal number three, you actually get the most amount of gold, so that's really cool for that one. I'm curious to see how these generate naturally in the overworld. I would love to be able to find these, so I am going to be doing some exploring. And if I find anything cool, I'll show it in a video later on in life. I just want to take a look at the loot, and here is number three, like I said. You've got two gold blocks there, you've got one over there, and you've got one up top. That really is the cool part about number three. Nice, we've got golden tools in here. Now that those actually mean something in the game. I love the lava. I love the fact that it has netherrack, and I can't wait to see these things out in the wild. Guys, that's what I wanted to show you today. Going through all the structures, and we'll see if we can do something like this, a little showcase for all of them. And I also want to go through the structure blocks for the nether fortress and see what kind of changes they made there. You guys have been asking for that a lot. So hopefully you liked the video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button. If you loved it, make sure you subscribe in the Centronet. And I'm out. Thanks for watching.